read Ephesians 4, verse 11 to 12, which says, "And he gave some to be apostles, prophets, evangelists, pastors, and teachers, to equip the saints for the work of the ministry and for the building up of the body of Christ." Romans 10, 14 to 15 says, "How then shall they call on him in whom they have not believed? And how are they to believe in him of whom they have never heard? And how are they to hear without someone preaching to them? And how are they to preach unless they are sent? As it is written, how beautiful are the feet of those who preach the gospel." And Hebrews 5, 4 says regarding the office of the ministry, "No one takes this honor upon himself, but only when called by God." In accordance with the word of God, our Lutheran confessions teach that in order to obtain justifying faith, God instituted the office of the preaching of the gospel and administering the sacraments. Augsburg Confession, Article 5. And that no one should publicly preach, teach, and administer the sacraments without a right call. Augsburg Confession, Article 14. Therefore, in accordance with the Holy Scripture and our Lutheran Confession, we have gathered here today to rightly call Jake Zabel into the office of the Holy Ministry of Word and Sacrament. In his letter to St. Titus, St. Paul gave the command to appoint ministers in every town. Therefore, I invite Jake forward to participate in this rite of ordination and to receive his appointment as a minister of our Lord's Church. Jake, having completed theological and pastoral studies and having undergone due examination, you have been found well versed in the Christian doctrine and apt to teach others, and have been called to the office of the Holy Ministry. It is fitting and right that we should ponder what the Word of God says concerning his ministers and the solemn responsibilities of their sacred office. If anyone aspires to the office of bishop, he desires a noble task. Therefore, a bishop must be above reproach, the husband of one wife, sober-minded, self-controlled, respectable, hospitable, apt to teach, not a drunkard, not violent, but gentle, not quarrelsome, not a lover of money. He must manage his own household well, with all dignity, keeping his children submissive. For if someone does not know how to manage his own household, how will he care for God's church? He must not be a recent convert, or he may become puffed up with conceit and fall into condemnation of the devil. Moreover, he must be well thought of by outsiders, so that he may not fall into disgrace, into a snare of the devil. 1 Timothy 3:1-7. If anyone is above reproach, the husband of one wife, and his children are believers, and not open to the charge of debauchery or insubordination. For a bishop, as God's steward, must be above reproach. He must not be arrogant or quick-tempered or drunkard or violent or greedy for gain, but hospitable, a lover of good, self-controlled, upright, holy and disciplined. He must hold firm to the trustworthy word as taught, so that he may be able to give instruction in sound doctrine and also to rebuke those who contradict it. Titus 1:6-9. And the next is, this is how one should regard us, as servants of Christ and stewards of the mysteries of God. Moreover, it is required of stewards that they be found faithful. 1 Corinthians 4:1-2. If you put these things before the brothers, you will be a good servant of Christ Jesus, being trained in the words of the faith, of the good doctrine that you have followed. Have nothing to do with irreverent, silly myths. Rather, train yourself for godliness, for while bodily training is of some value, godliness is of value in every way, as it holds promises for the present life and also for the life to come. The saying is trustworthy and deserving of full acceptance. For to this end we toil and strive, because we have our hope set on the living God, who is the Savior of all people, especially of those who believe. Command and teach these things. Let no one despise you for your youth, but set the believers an example in speech, in conduct, in love, in faith, in purity. Until I come, devote yourself to public reading of Scripture, to exhortation, to teaching. Do not neglect the reading. Do not neglect the gift you have, which was given you by prophecy when the council of elders laid their hands on you. Practice these things. Immerse yourself in them so that all may see your progress. Keep a close watch on yourself and on the teaching. Persist in this, for by so doing you will save you both yourselves and your hearers. 1 Timothy 4, 6-16. Do your best to present yourself to God as approved, a worker who has no need to be ashamed, rightly handling the word of truth. 2 Timothy 2:15. Teach what accords with sound doctrine. Titus 2:1. Preach the word, be ready in season and out of season. Reprove, rebuke, and exhort with complete patience and teaching. 2 Timothy 4:2. We have thus heard from scripture that ministers are ambassadors of Christ, and as such are to preach the word and administer the holy sacraments. They are called not to watch over geese or cows, but over the church, which is the bride of Christ, to offer before him the prayers and supplication of his people, to feed, to instruct, to watch over and guide the sheep and lambs of his flock, to give him themselves wholly to this holy office with daily meditation and study of the holy scriptures, and to conduct themselves in decent and honorable living, and to rule their house, wife, and children in a Christian manner. Do you believe the canonical books of the Old and New Testament to be the inerrant, inspired word of God and the only infallible rule for faith, life, and doctrine?
I do.
Do you hold and confess the doctrine of the Evangelical Lutheran Church as laid down in the Lutheran Confessions in the Book of Concord of 1580?
I do.
Do you intend to faithfully fulfill the duties of the Holy Ministry in full accordance with the Holy Scriptures and the Confessions of the Evangelical Lutheran Church?
I do.
Do you intend to conduct your life in a decent and honorable manner as commanded by the Word of God?
I do. Jake, Zachary, Zabel, swear and promise in holiness before God. Firstly, I am confident in both heart and conscience that I am lawfully called to this sacred office in such a way that I have neither secretly nor openly used any kind of God-forbidden means to obtain this office. Secondly, I promise that with the utmost care I will work to that end, that the heavenly doctrine contained in the prophetic and apostolic writings of the Holy Scriptures and in the confessional writings of the Lutheran Church must be faithfully impressed upon my listeners, that the sacraments must be administered reverently and entirely in accordance with the word and command of Christ, that church discipline must be carefully exercised, that the doctrine of the Catechism must be taught and promoted, and that only orthodox rites and practices are adopted in the church. Thirdly, I give this serious and sacred promise that I will not only flee and abhor that doctrine which is against the word of God, but I will also, to the best of my ability, fight the same, as I would rather see my blood shed than to allow false and fanatical teaching to be welcomed into the church. Fourthly, I will diligently read and study the Holy Scriptures, and with the same thoroughness also the articles of faith of the Lutheran Confessions, as I will not let any day go by where I do not spend any time on sacred reading, unless illness or incessant obstacles prevent it. Fifthly, I will lead a life worthy of the service of the Word of God, carefully striving to make myself a shining light by a praiseworthy piety, righteousness, and holy living, that I may never, ever knowingly give myself over to any evil living, that I may become a disgrace to the glory of God or to this sacred and venerable office. Sixth and last, I commit and promise with fear of God that I will interact with my fellow pastors and brothers in Christ in such a way that no one can reasonably bring charges against me or a cause to do so. All this I promise to adhere to, and I truly desire from the heart that God will help me to do so by His Holy Spirit.
Upon your confession and oath, I hereby acknowledge your call and ordain you as a called and able minister of the gospel, a herald of the kingdom of God, an ambassador of Christ, and a steward of the mysteries of God. The Lord pour out His Holy Spirit upon you for the office and work committed to you by this call, that you may be a faithful and dutiful dispenser of the means of grace, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us pray. Lord Jesus Christ, the chief shepherd and only head of the church, you have said that the harvest is plentiful, but the laborers are few. Pray therefore that the Lord of harvest will send forth laborers into his harvest. Upon this your command, we pray that you would keep your servant in your holy word and sound doctrine. Send forth your Holy Spirit upon him and strengthen him in the faithful performance of the duties of the ministry, and bless his labors in your service, that your holy name may be glorified and that your word may spread to the ends of the earth. Amen. Our Father, who is in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive those who are indebted to us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For yours is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. Jake, Jesus commanded Saint Peter to feed my sheep. In turn, Saint Peter said to the pastors of the Church of God, shepherd the flock of God that is among you, exercising oversight, not under compulsion, but willingly, as God would have you, not for shameful gain, but eagerly, not domineering over those in your charge, but being examples to the flock. And when the chief shepherd appears, you will receive the unfading crown of glory. Likewise, Sir Paul said to the pastors of Ephesus, pay careful attention to yourself and to all the flock, in which the Holy Spirit has made you overseers, to care for the church of God, which he obtained with his own blood. Go then and take heed of yourself and all the flock, over which the Holy Spirit has made you an overseer. Feed the flock of Christ, teach them, instruct them, rebuke them, and guide them. Receive this stone as a mark of your office, remembering that you are a servant of God and His church.
He said, let us bless the Lord.
God be praised forevermore.
The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord look upon you with favor and grant you peace. Amen.